And now back to Property Source Radio with your hosts, Steve and Pat. This segment is brought to you by The Mall Board. Tell your friends to meet me at The Mall Board.
I want to remind you, the new West Side edition of Property Source News is on the streets. Pick it up at Grease Ridge Mall Board, and you can also pick it up at all Tops locations on the West Side. Talking this morning with Alan Wood. He's the owner and partner of RE/MAX Plus in Brighton, and Allison Liam Bruno is with us as well. Ugly Alan Wood.
Yes, that is it. That actually stemmed from the 10 Ugly Men, which we started 22 years now ago. A group of guys from Nazareth started it out, and Tums was our first sponsor. And so we had to come up with a name that was rhymed with Tums, and that's how we came up with 10 Ugly Men, because there was 10 of us that ran it.
So, wow. Oh, that's how it came up. How did you get a sponsor, Tums, from the local area?
Local guys knew him. And okay. So I don't know if it was Mike Cartman. He's our godfather. Yeah. He's the founding father of it. And but I'm not sure who. And so we've been doing that, and that's in July.
If you're not familiar with the 10 Ugly Men, it's a group of, it's a nonprofit organization founded, as you said, back in 1989. One goal in mind, and that's to host parties and donate proceeds to local charities. I mean, that really says it all.
And it's funny because people always come up to me, how much do you make off it? I go, I lose money off it because I donate so much time. We don't take a penny. We're a 501c3. All goes to charity.
And of course, you know, Alan, you're a perfect example of the level of professionals who are involved in this group.
Yes, we actually do have a quite good group of professionals in our organization. So we strive for that, and it keeps growing with that.
Lawyers, bankers, college professors.
Lawyers, bankers, we have them. We have people that work for Paychex, Paytech, all different things.
You're almost like Nick and the Nice Guys, except without the music.
It's, you know, funny. People think we're a band.
Yeah, well.
It's funny. Oh, 10 Ugly Men, I love your band. I'm like, oh, really? Okay, because we have music at the event, but they think we're a band, so it's funny.
Wow. I got to say, it's an incredible event. I've gone the last 2 or 3 years, and it's fascinating. You have to put a lot of work into it. I mean, it's just fascinating.
We do put a lot of work into it between trying to get sponsors and just going out and trying to get people there. You have to promote the event. And we started out by going out to get people, handing out business cards like I did here.
Yeah.
And then about 8 years ago, we started our second event, and it's a little bit different committee, but this one's the Ugly Disco, and there's three of us started it together that were on the 10 Ugly Men with a fourth person, and then now there's two of us that are on both organizations that are running it.
Now, if someone wants to use you, your organization, to help them raise money, is that how you go about it? You can help them hold an event, or what?
Well, people have asked us to do that. Unfortunately, we don't do that. We would like to, but it's just such a time commitment. And with the two events we have right now, we just really can't fit any others. And so we'll go to other people's events and help them. Like the Memorial Art Gallery had us all dress up in disco, come there and help them on one of their psychedelic events. So things like that, we're willing to help out and for free.
All right, I'm willing to close my eyes here and picture you in your getup. Give me a metal picture.
Okay. Well,
everybody, unless you're driving, close your eyes.
I have to get it all made, okay, because I don't fit in anything off the rack. And
well, you're 6'7" for crying out loud.
Basically, like white pants. You have a bell bottoms with a slit in them that match your shirt on the sides.
Okay.
You have any color shirt, blue, pink. I have a pink shirt, pink hat. I don't care. Mm-hmm. It's pretty funny. And but that's what I wear with the hat. Of course, you have to have the platform shoes.
Yes, and let me remind you that Alan Wood is the owner and partner of RE/MAX Plus in Brighton.
So you wear platform shoes, so then you're like 9 feet tall?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I am about 6'10 then, and I'll tell you one thing. We've been in the parade in the past, and it's not fun walking 2 miles with platform shoes on. Yeah, I will tell you
just
that.
Getting the bus.
Now he knows how we feel when we have to wear heels.
Amen, sister. Amen. Well,
but the good thing is you can pick out Alan at a crowd of 3,000.
Yes, you can.
It's that guy over there.
See, I can't picture you as you're driving to the event.
It is funny because people do look at you.
Yeah.
How about getting out of your car and getting gas on the way? And you get out and you're there and everyone's looking at you like, where are you going?
Spend the extra 9 cents and go to full service.
Yes, that's
what it's worth it. Now, Allison, do you get involved in this too?
I do some volunteer work at the front door and such, but you just kind of go have a good time.
She just comes and has a good time. We have
laughs
to
at you. Yeah. Do you get dressed up?
I do get dressed up.
Well, let's see yours.
Typically, it's a small dress with big heels really straight hair and tons of makeup. So
That's
kind of the garb. But I'm probably one of, what, 5,000 that look like that?
Yes, exactly.
We almost need appropriate music for this.
Do you want to hear something? Allison and Alex, you guys are going to appreciate this. Last year, I went to one of the, those, where they buy the used clothes.
Consignment store.
Yeah, and I went to buy some ugly disco garb. I literally found my wife's going to kill me. A women's size 8 leather pants that I wore last year.
Huh? That's great. Goodness.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
it hurt a little, but it looked good. It looked 70s.
Hey, the slim pants are coming back.
Too bad the slim pat's not coming back. That's the only problem.
The slim Steve is.
Oh, no, yeah, right. Those days are long gone. So February 26th is your next event.
Yes, that's our ugly disco at the convention center. We get about 3,500 people. We've been growing about 500 people every year. There's hotel packages.
Great idea.
Take a look at the hotel. Go to the website, uglydisco.com, and you can see there's some really good hotel packages. The hotel room's practically free with some of the packages. And then you don't have to drive. And thanks to Jeff, we're on all the mall boards, so you can look at that from the property source in the malls.
Jeff Haley, who's standing off on the side here. The overall website for the 10 Ugly Men is 10uglymen.com. But, you know, it's such a great idea to give people an opportunity to just come downtown and then stay overnight.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's definitely no driving. We also have shuttle buses that run all along Park Avenue area. We have three or four of them that run throughout there. It's one that goes to Pineapple Jack's if you want to get picked up there. So we don't want people driving. Just come have fun. Your ticket does include some drinks. Then if you want to indulge more, you just have to buy some. But it all goes to charity.
All goes to charity. And it's just a fun night of music. And
Three bands play music. Sky Coasters, Fever, the Wrath of Polyester, and Atlas, which are all fantastic bands. And Doug's our DJ. And we also have the Village Guys and a couple other routines this year, some new things this year. And Twister.
Twister.
Sweet.
Allison, you play Twister?
Oh, geez, I was going
to
ask her.
I have been known to play a mean game of Twister every now and again.
Really?
All right. Now we're talking.
Yes.
You should just have a fun game of Twister here and now.
That's it. Her heels can touch two different colors at once. They're so long.
Right hand red.
I'll bet they can.
Sweet.
Right hand red. She really does. Right. See, I'm the guy who's I'll spin the spinner.
Oh yeah. See, I might hurt something if I try to play.
Especially in those pants you're talking.
Pants. Exactly.
Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking about.
Leather pants and left foot blue just don't go good together.
We're going down a weird path here.
We're gonna get some pictures this year of Pat, and so we gotta get Steve there too.
Should I wear the same pants?
Steve, are you gonna do the ugly disco?
I've done it. I've been there. Oh yeah.
Do you dress up?
Our station, The Buzz, is always involved. Yes. With the 10 Ugly Men, everything we do.
Yeah, you guys have been involved for a long time, so you guys have been wonderful here.
Sweet. Oh, yeah, they do the Ugly Idol, where you find the band that plays at the Summer Fest.
We do that for our 10 Ugly Men in the summer, yes.
And the summer event is a whole different thing, right?
Yeah, that's July 24th this year, a whole different thing. That's outdoors, music, volleyball, 5K race. This year we're going to have an ugly obstacle race, I think, that you can compete in, and you can win tickets and so forth. It's going to be interesting. You know, you have to go so far, and then you have to eat part of an ugly plate that we're coming up with.
Oh boy.
So we've got some interest. You won't want that, but it's not on the Weight Watchers diet.
Oh, that's awesome.
Too many points.
It'll be a cheat day. Yeah. Not with the points, but with the relay race. I'll cheat my way through that.
Yes, you can.
Website is 10uglymen.com. I'm sure we can put a link on our Property Source website so you can get to that.
That's for our summer one, and then the uglydisco.com is for the winter one in February.
When do you have time to work?
Between those, it does take a lot of time actually out. So they know like the last week of February is tough for me before the event. And in July, the same thing. It's tough always that last week because still running around trying to get things finalized. But we find time.
And we'll see you in the St. Paddy's Day Parade, of course.
We are usually in there. Unfortunately, we are not able to be in the parade anymore.
Oh, really?
Did you get thrown out?
Yeah, it's a few years ago. Oh. 2 years ago, we were just handing out candy.
I remember.
Just like every other float in the parade, and they happened to throw us out, and no one else.
Any reason?
They said you're not allowed to throw candy, and we were walking along the sides, throwing it 4 feet, but everybody else was doing it. We were the ones they decided to throw out.
Oh, wow. Okay.
The outfits had nothing to do with it.
That was probably it.
All right, so check the website, 10uglymen.com and uglydisco.com. Two great events coming up with the 10 Ugly Men. Fantastic group. They have the Ugly Disco and then the big summer event as well. All right, we're going to take another break. We will be back and talk a little more. I got a couple things. And now you two can hang around for this because I got a couple things that are kind of interesting to talk about. Would you buy a celebrity's house? Something on my mind. We'll get to that next. It's Property Source Radio, Sports Radio 950 ESPN.